What's up, y'all?
Shut up. My stupid dogs. What's up? I don't know if it's my headset that's messed up or what. Bruh, I can't play creative. Better radio. Who is this? Screaming.
Oh, hello, Junior. What you doing? Junior! 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 Okay.
I can't do all that. Say what's up if you're watching. I can't do all that. I don't even know who that was. I'm just gonna be a good teammate. Can y'all hear me or no? I was supposed to get on at 10, but my kid was extra tired. Say what's up in the chat if you're watching. Cover me for a second, please. Cover me for a second. Love you too.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Kick some ass.
Thank you. Say what's up if you're watching. Who are you shooting at?
Yeah. Well, she's been mainly doing Fortnite, but she's
gonna start doing a lot. Ooh, I knew that was about to do that. I need a shotgun. Okay, Jay the Realist, I'm going back to lobby. Something wrong with my chat.
Yeah. I have some deeper string and stuff like that.
Okay, let's see, where do we want to land?
I'll put my everything up in the backyard. Getting all this glass.
Can y'all hear me okay? Can y'all, is something wrong with my chat? Just let me know. Send me a snap or something and let me know. Oh shoot.
Yeah.
Sorry. Okay, good. Oh, we're back.
That'll be the rules. I done told them when it comes over here, so whatever rules you have affected your house, the same one too.
My radio. My bad, I'm trying to find out if my stuff is working good or not. Is my chat working? Can anybody chat? Because I don't know if it is or not. Oh, I always forget to thank the bus driver. Is the guy at?
If you get new
here. Period. I'm better with shotguns. I'm not saying I'm great, but I'm better. Oh shoot. That's not even fair. You trying to get a play right now or no? Yeah. Let me eat my old cheeks. I'm not playing with them. I don't know who that was. I think it was a kid. I don't know who it was, what I said. Can I? I'm trying to see if my chat's working or not. Huh? I know my talk's working. Who is this? This is cute. That's cute. already jumped. Oh God. Is she now? Got him. Or they do just be jumping. Oh God, okay. Don't kill my bot now. Thanks for the follow. Say what's up if you're watching. I'm trying to talk to people. I'm trying to see if my chat's really working or not. Because Doug's a moderator, so. I think it'll work for you regardless. What's good? Hey, Edward. We got all kind of new animes to watch because of Edward. We still gotta finish that one. The King's Game. Spooky story. I thought it was pretty spooky. But I'm gonna wait till 10 That's when I was supposed to be streaming anyways. Here. But I will say it's about an unexpected serial killer. Really heinous. Just know that could be anybody. Anybody around you could be serial killing. Ain't that weird, dog?
What?
To think about, like, Dexter or Joe Goldberg. Yeah, be serial killing on the weekends or something. Or on a Tuesday or...
It's going on.
Like... That's not cool, but... It's something to think about.
It's spooky.
Yeah, I like spooky stuff. That's why I don't know what to say. It's not cool. I wouldn't say it's cool, but...
It is cool.
It's interesting.
It's coming off on a Tuesday.
That's why I'm really about to start studying these. Spooky stories that I am. There's a lot of stuff that people don't know about.
I got two briefcases.
I do too. It ain't like you, they teach you that stuff in school or whatever. They just teach you like whatever, Pythagorean theorem, is that what it's called? Pythagorean theorem or something.
Yeah, you want to hit this thing and go somewhere else, or you can go
here? We can go somewhere else, I guess. Hit what? Alright.
You got a big man, big shield?
No, I gave you my last one. I don't think I can carry it unless you can carry these briefcases. Unless you want me to carry.
You want that shield, or what do you want to do? This I can just knock people out of the way with.
I'll carry it. Alright.
Here goes another one.
Dog, I know you didn't. I'm not carrying that. I'm carrying briefcase. Did you do that or no?
Did I do what?
Viewers.
This thing
down here? Huh? Did I do what?
Oh. Yeah.
I thought I did it on my own. Alright, I'm better run. But, like I said, I ain't gonna be telling a spooky story. So I'm gonna start at 10. Of course, I'm big. Playing in between. So it'll take me a little while. What are you marking? Yeah. Oh. Alright, I'm going to circle, I'm going to the cache. Say what's up if you're watching. need all of that.
Well, I love this thing, dude.
Ooh, an epic. That's a good thing about this computer, though. It's like a little space heater. Thanks, buddy. Ooh, yeah, boy.
Your slurp right there, too,
though. No, I don't want that.
Is he ready?
I just say, yeah, I don't want it.
You don't want it?
No, I'm good. Say what's up. That sounded like I was about to sing the national anthem. I wasn't. You wanna go to our shots?
Sure.
So I was gonna try to tell a story about the pint size slasher. I don't know if anybody knows who that is, but it's a fictional character, and I thought it was based on a real character, but I was sadly mistaken. But it's from Fallout 3, Tranquility Lane, if anybody knows what that is. But I've just always been intrigued by that. And there's somebody else shooting at him too, huh? But yeah, I wanted it to be real so bad. Pint size slasher. Alright, I'm going down there if you're going down. You put your briefcase down?
No.
Oh.
I just wanted to use that hammer. Thank you.
But if anybody has any good non-fictional characters, fictional characters based on true things that I can research, that would be cool. The one I was gonna do?
Yeah.
The pint size slasher. Pint size slasher.
What about that one from Ed's
Horse? I don't know if it was a kid or if it was a little person, but they kept their mask and their knife in a doghouse in the simulation, and at the end of it you had to Either, I think he had to kill somebody. I'm not trying to tell nobody, but I mean, Fallout 3 is so old. If you ain't played it by now, you probably won't play it. A Fallout fanatic. I love everything about it. So, everything on there intrigues me. I don't think we're too impressed with 76, but I wish they would just bring Nuclear Winter back.
So I'm telling you.
Then I would play that all the time. I do like some what?
You got room for another briefcase?
No. I do like some updates they have, like the Nuka Cola. But it's really time consuming. I'm gonna get in this grass right here. There's grass, and I think someone died right here, maybe. Say what's up if you're watching. Is that a gold? Looks like it. Yep.
Where?
I just marked it.
You need to go get it?
No, it's a scoped burst.
Four people up.
SMG. Oh, there were shots over there. Or something over there.
There's three people left. You gonna start heading behind here?
I'm about to head towards this bush over here. Ooh, footsteps.
Should I drop the turrets?
Yeah, at the very last second. See if they'll start fighting first. Maybe. Two versus two, me and my mate. Who are you? I ain't trying to say I'm that good or nothing. But, I mean, you probably suck anyways.
See?
Yep. I'm just kidding. I'm just talking mess. Oh, there's grass. There's grass up there. No, but there's two. Okay, there's two people left. They're gonna be able to see us from up top.
That's where they're at too. I just seen them.
Up top.
I think I did.
I think we should get up against this rock and then start moving.
You got a bounce right there?
Where? Sure, I guess. Be ready to throw the turret down. There's footsteps right here. You ready? Huh?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, there they are. We gotta get in that circle. Oh, shit. Alright, I'm coming. I'm gonna try and throw this turret down. That sucks. Yeah, one of them was. Two versus two. You want two versus this person? Yeah, I gotta tell a spooky story anyways. Have you heard of the giggling granny?
The giggling granny?
Yep.
No. They don't sound very attractive.
Black widow. Lonely hearts killer. You ever heard of any of those?
No.
So that is all the nicknames for this one. Sweet little lady. Her name was Nanny Doss. I thought that was like her nanny name. But no, that was her name, Nanny. She was born in 1905. And she died in 1965. And kind of scarier for us, not really, but you know where Anniston is?
Where's that?
North Alabama.
Okay.
That's where she was born.
Birmingham area, right?
Yeah, it was actually Blue Mountain, like that long ago, but it's now Anniston. But, I think she had three sisters and a brother, one brother. But she had like a real controlling dad. He wouldn't let her like wear makeup or any kind of stuff like that. And then she wanted to read like romance novels all the time. And he wouldn't let her do that. I'm about to go to the farm, I guess. But yeah, so that's her dynamic. Well, I can't say that, but I can't say not date, but she couldn't fantasize about it or anything like that. And then he didn't let none of them go to school. Like, he made them stay home and do chores and stuff like that. So that's just the dynamic of her childhood. And there was a specific incident that happened whenever they were traveling, and they were traveling on a train, and the train stopped abruptly, and it hit her head on the thing in front of her, and caused her to have blackouts, headaches, you know, mood swings, just act out of character when she was 9. So that seems to be an important part of her story, but I can't really prove it. Okay, I'm about to die. Girls are bad at Fortnite. I don't know. I guess. You're bad. You're bad at spelling. Hate to tell you. No, I'm just kidding. That's your opinion, I guess. I ain't shower the best. Especially since we don't build or nothing. But so yeah, that happened whenever she was 9. She loved reading the Lonely Hearts column. I don't know if you remember me saying the Lonely Hearts Killer.
Yeah.
Keep that in mind. And the reason why I said we couldn't say that she didn't necessarily date is because at the age of 16, she got married. Now let me just break it to y'all. This giggling granny supposedly killed 11 people. And that's why it's so scary, because of the people that she supposedly killed was closest to her in every way. But anyways, okay, back to 16, she gets married. Her father wanted her to get married to this man. Let me see who it was. Charlie Braggs. Okay, she was only married to him for like 7 years, but she did have her 4 kids with this man. It was the only man that she had kids with. So she had her, she had 4 kids, and then her and her first husband, Charlie, did they ended up not doing so well. He was alcoholic. They both cheated on each other. So it wasn't a real good relationship anyways, but then all of a sudden her two middle girls, she had all girls, her two middle ones mysteriously died of food poisoning. Well, you gotta think, this is like, this is in the 1920s, so they didn't have a whole lot of technology to prove, gosh dang it, to prove what killed somebody. So her two middle died. Her husband's mother ended up living with them. And then he took off with the oldest, left her with the newborn. So now this lady, she's got a newborn and she lives with her mother-in-law of a man that she's cheating on and just left her, because I think he was afraid about his two children just dying. Then eventually the mother-in-law passed away. They have no idea how or why. So then her husband returns. He actually brings his mistress with him and her child. So they end up getting divorced. They sign divorce papers and she takes both of her daughters with her. So that's marriage number one. Then she gets married again in 1929. He was an alcoholic. Even though he was an alcoholic, I think this was her longest marriage. She was married to him for 16 years. And she was actually the one who would cheat on him. I don't think she suspected him of anything. However, I don't really care. I guess we can go right there. I like going in the snow. But, however, in 1945, Robert Harrelson, this is her second husband, he ends up raping her because, you know, he's an alcoholic. Some people don't believe in rape within a marriage, but it can happen. He raped her. Well, the next day she puts rat poison in his, I'm gonna go right here, puts rat poison in his whiskey and he dies that night. So there's confirmed death number one. Okay, let me find this house. Okay, also, during that time, she did have, like I said, she had her two daughters with her. Well, one of them got married and had a baby. I believe his name was Robert. So she has a little boy. She also had a second little boy a couple of years later. Now, the second little boy, he did not make it that long. He, let me see, I think he died. Okay. He died, and the doctors found a hole in his head, Doug, do you know what a hat pin is?
A hat pin?
Yeah.
No.
I think it's talking about one of them pins that has a little colored ball on the end. Did your grandma ever sew or anything like that? You know how they stick the needle in the little...
Oh, I got you. So the big pin.
Yeah. Well, so the husband of the daughter and the sister told the doctors that they saw her with the hat pin, with Nanny. She had a hat pin, and supposedly he died from a hat pin. So she killed her less than a month old grandson, is what they are suspecting. And then, 2 months later, the big brother, Robert, he dies from asphyxiation while under Nanny's care. So, she killed both of her grandsons. Kills both of her children's, I mean her oldest child's sons. And then it was 2 months later she collected an insurance policy on Robert for $500. This was in the 40s, I believe. Yeah, so her daughter was like in her 20s, and then.
So that's victim number one.
That's victim. Well, not really sure. Because you have suspected, you have the two daughters, and then you have the mother-in-law, and then you have her husband, her second husband. She didn't get to kill her first husband, but. She killed the second one, and then she had two of her grandsons. So that should be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's 6 people right there within a matter of like 20 years that she killed, all in her family. I guess not. And then, okay, so, shocker, she goes in the Lonely Hearts columns, the ones that she was forbidden to read when she was young, and she looks for husband number 3. Husband number 3, it was Arlie Lanning. Oh, excuse me. Yeah, she... Okay. She, all of a sudden, he dies from heart failure. I don't even think they was married a year. He dies of heart failure. It's what they're suspecting. And I actually had to read... I read through a couple of different sources. Because some people are saying 11 victims, some people say it was 12, and then you have to read through your sources to get more details than what you would get just reading one. Why'd you shoot them? But oh, that's the guy with the key card. Okay. So yeah, they wouldn't even married a year and then he died. And we're pretty sure it was from the rat poison again. Which they'll tell you, like, rat poison, it was a very common household item, arsenic. Before, you know, people put a big old danger label on top of it. Yeah. And then, let's see. But yeah, he had a house. The house they lived in actually belonged to his sister. So she kills her husband. And then she burns down the house because it belonged to the sister. But because she was married, you know, to the husband, she collected the insurance money. So of course she went on about her way. That was husband number three. And then she actually went to live with her sister after that. Now her sister was bedridden, not really sure what was wrong with her, but she was bedridden. Soon after, Nanny goes to live with her sister. Her sister dies. Yep. Alright, now we're getting into the later years. 1952. So, these are some of the last years of her life. I think we're at a count of 8, maybe. So she's got a few more sprees left in her system. But, so she meets husband number 4, Zipline. She meets husband number 4 on a dating, they have dating clubs in the 1950s and 40s. I think it was called like Diamond Call or something like that, but it was pretty much a dating thing. Well, she meets her husband, and then let's see, like this was the one that she gets, huh? Yeah, no, she didn't get caught up on this one yet. Where are you at? Alright, I'm gonna get up in here real quick. Somebody said YouTube, Hilton 2008. Say what's up if you're watching. Okay, the Diamond Circle Club. She meets Richard Morton. This was her 4th marriage. Okay, yeah, during, I think she pretty much had affairs with all her, on all her husbands, but, so that wasn't nothing new, but, her father actually passes away. Her mother, suffers from a fall and gets sick. So she has nobody to take care of her. Her mother comes to live with her. I think it was not even 3 months. She poisoned her mom and killed her. Somebody's shooting at me. And then, I think it was because Morton suspected her. Probably. I'm running to you. Where are you at? Up top. Somebody's shooting at me. No, they're like right behind me, I think. But I think he got suspicious of her, so of course she shoot him in the butt.
Shot her in the butt.
Yep, shot him in the butt. Alright, and then, so yeah, 3 months later, she poisons Morton and kills him. Okay, so she weren't married to him not even a year either. Now, 1953, this was like 2 or 3 months after she poisoned Morton. She marries, what was he? I think he was like a doctor, maybe. Named Samuel Doss. This is where her last name comes from. Nanny Doss. There's shots to the east. So, he wasn't no dummy like the other ones kind of was, you know. I was about to say how I hit him for 99.33. Alright, I'm gonna go in with a shotgun. But he started getting sick, so he went to the hospital. They kept him there for a few months, and during this time Nanny takes out a couple of life insurance policies on him. So he gets out in August 1953. She had poisoned him, I think it was like 5 days later. She poisons him. No, I killed him. She poisons him and puts rat poison in his coffee. Like, literally 5 days after he got out of the hospital. Yeah, so his doctor finds out about it. And his doctor was like, hey, that ain't right. So he orders an autopsy. Somebody on the ice. He orders an autopsy and finds like he's full of arsenic whenever they did the autopsy. So she was immediately arrested. She was immediately arrested after that. That's how she gets caught. This was in, she committed murders in Alabama, Arkansas, Oklahoma, and I think it was North Carolina. And then, so she was arrested in Oklahoma though. And she confesses to her, all of her husbands, her mom. Yeah, what do you want? I had it. You want something else? She confesses to, yeah, her husbands, all four of them, the mother, the sister, the grandsons, and the mother-in-law.
So all of them she confessed to?
Or just yeah, I think it was all of them. Now, I did read somewhere else that there was two other children. Oh, yeah, it was her two kids. That's, she didn't confess to those. But, you know, of course, they think she did it. Anyways, there's shots right behind me, footsteps. Thanks for the follow. Oh God. I'm almost dead. They decided to only charge her with DOS or Trier. With a green. Alright, well, they only tried her on Doss's, her last husband. I guess that was the only one they had the autopsy on. Huh? Yeah, that was a while ago. But she pled guilty for DOS, of course, and she already confessed to like 500 murders already. She was sentenced to life. What's crazy is they wouldn't give her the death penalty. Why do you think that was? Nope. It's in the 50s. Nope.
See if people in the comments can guess.
Do y'all know why somebody wouldn't get the death penalty? Specifically, Nanny Doss. Why she would not get the death penalty in 1950s. Let me know if y'all know. I'll give it about 10 minutes, maybe. It's a pretty easy answer. So just a recap, we have a giggling granny. What's her nickname?
One of many.
She had a bad childhood. She had an accident when she was a child, hit her head. She goes through men like underwear. She gets married 5 different times. She kills 4 of them. She has 4 kids. We think that she kills 2 of them. She killed her only 2 grandchildren. She kills her mother and one of her mother-in-laws. She kills one of her sisters. And she finally gets caught up on the last husband that she kills. So we are at that point. She gets found guilty. They would not give her the death penalty. So I need to know why y'all think Nanny Doss would not get the death penalty in 1950s. They did try to blame it on her accident. I'm not gonna make it all the way over there. I'm gonna make it to right here, this gas station.
The farm.
I'm gonna make it right here. At the trailer park. Oh. tomorrow we gotta start. I am starting my 100 hours of gaming. We're gonna be playing games for 100 hours in the month of September for Stand Up to Cancer. I have a fundraiser started. My goal is $200. I am already at $25. So I think we can do a little bit better than 200. I won't be streaming 100 hours. Maybe. But I'll definitely be playing 100 hours. Comment if you're watching, and comment if you know why she wouldn't get the death penalty. Just rebooted. They're flying in. Let's see. I need some ammo, boy. Alright, I'm out this. There's like 3 people around me, 4 people. Y'all can fight each other, I don't care. Oh shoot. I'm gonna kill their little partner. I don't have any ammo. Shotgun ammo. Why is my gun not working, boy? Okay. SFG Justin made me self-conscious. Alright. They will not give her the death penalty because she was a woman.
That was it.
Yep. They didn't give women the death penalty back then. So she, of course, she ends up dying in there, but she dies from leukemia. So.
Yeah.
I do need to check on him. Second. But that was the story of Nanny Doll. So that's why I think that one was just really crazy. She literally killed her kids, her everybody close to her. That's why I said it's like having Joe Goldberg or Dexter. But the thing about her was you could see it in pictures that she was small. And even when they brought her in after the last guy, she in the interview, she was just like, right here. She was just acting like she was having like a Sunday brunch or something with the police officers. It's kind of funny. Talking about how she just murdered her husband. But it can literally be anybody. You're really gonna shoot me from the bottom of the thing. But I will be doing another. I'll be doing scary stories every Tuesday and Thursday. If y'all want to come just chat, I'll be on Monday. I'm sure that I'll be on a whole lot more than that, anyways. Why are she new? Is that all of them? I killed the last one, I think. But if there's somebody specific that y'all want to hear about, please let me know. Because I like knowing about all that kind of stuff. Horror stories. My zip line in.
Footsteps.
Over here.
Up top or down?
Down. Thanks for the follow, Mars Hub. All right. Is there somewhere you want to go?
Somebody?
I say, is there somewhere you want to go?
You want to go search this safe right here?
Yeah.
I doubt it's going to be available, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Mark probably got to it, but.
Yeah, there's somebody right there.
Where?
I just marked them. Shooting wrong. Oh. Cross. Boy, are you trying to bottom me out? Got him. By where?
That pool. They jumped down in that pool and then disappeared. You're in the safe room, hurry up.
I'm good on that, to be honest. Shot a camera. Got that RAM thing? Dang.
You wanna just roll?
Yeah. There's a vehicle. Right here. You can drive. I'm in there. You don't go. Huh? Mm-mm.
Here, bro.
What? Sword. Ooh, I knocked one of them. Ooh, that's another team. This food pool just got his reboot card. Alright. Dang, I got all kind of gold and stuff. He's behind this truck right here. Oh wait, this is a bot. Somebody's trying to. What, you need this? I don't know, but here. You gonna get those things? Shields? Where'd you go?
Is it safe?
Oh.
Hell yeah.
There's somebody shooting at me. I don't know. I'm gonna try to get this cachet, maybe. Rare. Let's see who's fighting. There's a briefcase over here, you know that? Oh boy. There you go. Where are they shooting from? A briefcase? Bro.
Come back over here and make it.
Hey, Miranda. What's up, Miranda? I think that's who was carrying me the other day. We can play trios if you want to.
He said it is.
Heck yeah.
I'm back out
of. You can play trios? Sure. I'm trying to figure out. Let's go, lobby. What is this? Llama loot. Change my thing real quick. Go with a Harley. Alright, what quest? I gotta search heist bags. What is heist bags?
Four black bags, double bag.
Huh?
Double bag.
Oh. Weekly.
There, I put my spooky guy in the lead.
Travel distance. All right, we gotta do that forecast data again from week zero. Hire a character in different matches. Lazy me. You know Lazy me's playing Fortnite. Right now. You might can hear. I don't think I can hear.
Can you hear me?
Oh yeah, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
No, I can't hear you through the thing, but I'm watching you on Twitch, so I can hear you on there.
Okay.
Between Fortnite and Twitch, it's like really delayed on Twitch.
Yeah. I wonder how I can fix that.
So if you say something to me, I might respond like maybe 10, 15 seconds later.
Alright. You wanna put your headset on? You wanna put your headset on? She can't hear me through my... She hears me on Twitch, not on the mic, so it's delayed. But if you wanna put yours on, she can hear you. Like, not delayed. Yeah, if you want to mark somewhere, we just follow you. If you got somewhere specific. Alright. Can you hear him?
No, I can't hear him.
Say he can hear you, but
can you hear me?
Yeah, he can hear you. Can you hear him?
Wait, I think I just seen like his voice thing move. Okay, hold on. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Oh, I can hear you now. Cool.
Good deal.
How you doing?
There's all these good blues.
Can't hear her.
It's probably because my my mic
probably
is you know how I got that mic on that disconnects though?
Yeah.
If she says something, are you her husband or something?
Yeah.
Okay, so y'all are in the same room or close to each other?
Uh-huh.
Okay, great. If she says something to me, just let me know, because, like, it's literally taken a whole minute for me to even, like, respond to her or anything, or for her to hear me and not hear her.
All right.
I know, I was thinking, should I mute that, or
well done.
I was thinking, should I mute that or turn that down? I can turn my desktop audio down on the stream. I'll hear it, but the other people won't hear it as loud.
Do y'all want to do treasure collect treasures, or do y'all want to do a bounty?
Surprise me.
I'm gonna meet you, Jade. All right. You can still hear her, right?
Yep.
Okay.
I hear the back of you too.
Oh, okay. I muted you, so she shouldn't be hearing you on mine anymore. Shots. Make sure you get their gold. More shots. You got it. Oh, there's two of them. We did 39 out of 50. I don't do snipers.
Going over there,
is that
the
Say what's up if you're watching.
I think I was watching y'all while I was at work the other day. Yeah.
You ain't gotta say that. I can say that.
I'm saying you said already ready identifying today.
She was good. Do you build? Are you a builder too, or no?
She said, "Are you a builder?" Yeah.
Oh god. So
you crank 90s.
Yeah, whatever they call it.
There goes briefcase definitely what I'm talking about. There, but I don't know.
Who is this, a low card? Here's a briefcase, done.
A briefcase? What? You thought you found it.